things start happening spontaneously, at that time you accept it, you don't have any choice in the sense. For example, you feel that you need to sit here, so you've been here, you know, that's come from your heart, it's not something which you have planned. So these are all acts which...
If you will accept, you still reserve the right to reject. If you will accept, then you reserve the right to reject. So all this talk of acceptance that is being touted as spirituality is pure nonsense. Who are you to accept? If you are accepting, then you are still on top of things. Who are you to accept? Some authority? Who are you? Huh? The spiritual mind accepts as well as rejects, but knows both of them to be worthless. Because acceptance and rejection are anyway happening daily. Are they not happening? You will choose what to eat this evening. You will accept something, you will reject something. It is happening. You don't have to accept something new. It is already happening. The game of accepting, liking, rejecting, disliking, it is continuously being played. When it is being played, then just know that it is being played. It is already happening, sir. It is already happening.
Yeah, but you don't know what whether you are selecting or not. In the sense, you have no choice in that.
Somebody is selecting.
Yes.
Somebody.
So, sometimes you know, you may look at this or somebody else may look at it and say, you are selecting, whereas I am not selecting.
Selection is happening.
Selection is happening.
Selection is happening. Yes. Just know.
Yeah, that is
along with the selection, you will always then come to know the selector. Because we do not know the selection itself, the whole game, we also do not know the selector. When you do not know the selector, you know what happens. You start assuming you are the selector. The wise man, he knows that the selector is the conditioning. You may say you are choosing a particular girl to marry, and you think you are the selector. But the wise one knows that the selection is happening only as per what I have been trained, taught, conditioned, made to believe in. But that happens only when you know that it is just happening, like something that happens in a system, in a machine. Pay attention to the selection, pay attention to the likes, dislikes. Don't you all dislike something? Don't we all like something? Are we not attracted to something? Does something not repulse us? Is that not happening all the time? When it is happening all the time, why do you need something more? All the hints, all the clues, the very solution is present in front of you. Why do you need anything else?
No, now in my case, you know, it is not so. Whatever comes, I accept.
You accept, right?
I accept means, you know, whatever is there at that point of time, that is, for example, if a mosquito is biting me, earlier I would swat it. Now I don't do it.
Now you don't do it, right?
Yes.
So you don't do it.
Yes, I don't do it means I think, yes.
You
yes,
don't do
yes.
it. You don't do it, right? You yes. are there. You are on top. You are the decider.
It's primarily because I think that my conditioned behavior is swatting, I should get rid of my conditioned behavior.
So you think, the
yes.
thinker is still there.
Yes.
What else is needed for the thinker? The thinker may keep thinking that he is not there, and in thinking that he is not there, he is still very nicely sustaining the thinker. What else does the thinker want?
So it's a backdoor entry.
It's a backdoor entry. Even this is a kind of sadhana, sir, to keep accepting. When you keep accepting, then you are still continuing with the old. You have all the right to reject. I have all the right to reject if somebody gives me milk. I don't take milk, I'll reject. And when I'll reject, there would be somebody who would probably smile. I can only guess. I do not know. Because I am busy accepting and rejecting. I am busy playing the game. I do not know what the watcher is like. I have no idea. I can only guess that he might be smiling. I reserve the right to reject. I have not forfeited it. I reserve the right to wear formals.
This I is who?
This I is ego.
And so in our daily lives, we have to face choices.
Yes.
So it's not anything wrong with that. But we just keep observing.
When the chooser is shown his right place, then the choices are divine. But when the chooser is sitting on top, then the choices are evil. Huh? If somebody is teaching you to not to choose, to live choicelessly, he is just enforcing a principle upon you. An impractical principle, because choosing will happen.
When will you know that the chooser is?
And when you will know, then you will declare to the entire world and put up a signboard and distribute pamphlets. Huh? Why do you want to know except for this? You want to know only so that you can announce, at least to yourself. If not to somebody else, if you tell it to somebody else, he will say, if you are enlightened, then why are you making such a show of it? But at least to yourself, you would like to silently whisper, what? I've done it.
So if you go by your heart and you feel...
Not your heart.
Your heart means if you go by the heart.
The heart, yes.
Yes. And you feel that this is the right choice at that point of time. Is that good enough?
You just keep feeling. Huh? Let the heart decide. The heart will decide. You feel, you think, you do whatever you want to do. You are a kid who is entitled to do everything and anything. Just don't rebel against the father. As a kid, you are enlightened to live life as you want to. Just remain one with the father. There is no need to give up anything, renounce. Or commit yourselves to some action. No, nothing. Just the umbrella of the Father, just the blessing of the Father is enough. The kid can keep playing. You are here not for a purpose. You are here just to play. Unbelievable. Do I have the right to play? Yes, you surely do have.